After a year of researching the effects of bullying on young people, I noticed that there was three types of kids. The kid who's bullied, then there's the bully, and then there's the bystander who's watching and doesn't know whether to get involved at all. Well, a lot of moms and dads might be wondering, well, how do I know which one is my kid? And we're scared to think, could my kid actually be a bully? Well, how do you know? Well, one thing is, as we notice what's going on in our kids' world, we can actually go to the definition of bullying. The definition of bullying has three almost check boxes that we could check to see if we're observing this kind of behavior. And that is, first of all, is there aggressive behavior? This isn't just teasing a friend on the sports court there. You know, this is kind of aggressively, almost belittling or something, which leads to the second check box, which is, it's a power play. In other words, I feel bad about myself, and so I'm gonna cut you down so I feel better about myself. That's a power play. So aggressive and power play. And the last checkbox is it repeated? This isn't a one-time thing where a kid loses their temper. This is going on again and again and again. So sometimes if we're observing our kids out playing sports or with their friends, are we seeing some of this stuff out of them? Are we seeing aggressive power plays over and over again? We can keep our eyes open for some of the warning signs. And frankly, in my chapter on the bully, I talk about some of the things we can look for, because there's also things like low self-esteem and seeing them engage in some of these power plays. And what can we do as moms and dads if we notice this stuff? Well, the best thing we can do is we can empathize with them and talk with them, because a bully feels bad about themselves, and that's why they're pushing others down. So we can talk with them about that, and we can listen to them, and we could try to dig in and find out why it is that they feel bad about themselves. Are you engaging in these conversations with your kids?